Absolutely, yes. There is no shortage of opportunity and there is no shortage of venture capital funding. The problem I see in India actually is twofold for entrepreneurs. If I think about entrepreneurship and emergence of companies, one is really, really skilled talent. Okay, there is really a complete dearth. I mean, if I compare, for example, I lived in Silicon Valley for a long period of time. If I look at the, if I, that's at a different end of the spectrum. But if I compare the talent pool being defined as everything, you know, product managers, project managers, you know, CTOs, CMOs, CEOs, that entire pool. If I look at that pool in Silicon Valley and I look at that pool in India, you know, on a scale of 1 to 10, if they are like 9 or 10, with, you know, let's say London being 7 or 8 or 6 or 7, I would put India as 1 or 2.
A long way to go. What will
Long way
change
to
it?
go. See, some of it is just doing it. The reason why the valley is filled with so many people, these are people who are second-time entrepreneurs, third-time entrepreneurs. They're derivatives from very successful companies who leave and then start up their own thing. So they've got a history. So I'm saying it'll happen. So if we are sitting and having this conversation 20 years from now, I feel confident that it'll happen because India has got smart people. They've got smart people and they've got hungry people. So it's going to happen. It's just a question of time. And there's nothing we can really do to accelerate that big time. You can churn out all the stuff you want from, you know, all the IIMs and all the rest of it, but that's not really what it is. It's just being there, having done it. So that takes time. The other thing that I'm worried about is the thing that I worry about more actually in India is more the macro picture of late. I'm becoming very concerned about the macro picture in India, both in terms of, you know, infrastructure, in terms of the regulatory involvement in industries like telecom, and the third thing is corruption. I believe these three things are going to keep India at the 6% growth rate, 6-7% growth rate, and a third world country forever. That's my biggest gripe.